He took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Benedict, our Pope Emeritus, Carl, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, in my name, I will be the teacher of my brethren. Let me see the word of my Lord, shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, healing us the wounds of that fault from which in a singular way you preserved Blessed Mary in her Immaculate Conception. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The only other announcement is on the very day of the 8th, tomorrow at 6:30 p.m., we'll also have Mass for the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. It will be bilingual. One moment, please. I should have marked this with you. Bow your heads, pray for God's blessing. May God, who through the child Mary and the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, may he be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
And may you know always and everywhere the protection of her through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen. Amen.
And may you, having devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may Almighty and may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, and Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
And Holy Michael the Archangel,
angel, defend us at the battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking for his souls.